math test mixed up. Emily couldn't wait to get her math test back. She had studied hard and knew she had done well. Mrs. Mead handed back all the test tests, but Emily didn't get her test. Joe didn't get his test either. "I have two tests without names," Mrs. Mead said. "Do you know which test is yours?" "Yours?" Mrs. Mead asks Emily and Joe. Emily and Joe looked at the papers. One test had one mistake, but the other had 15 mistakes. Emily reached for a paper with one mistake. "This one is mine," she said. Joe said, "No, I think it's mine." "It looked like my writing," Emily said. "It looked like mine too," Joe said. Emily stomped her foot and said, "I know it's mine." "Your name isn't on," Joe said. "Neither is yours," Emily and Mac. "There's only one thing to do since you can't decide," Mrs. Mead said. "What's that?" Emily and Joe asked. "Will you both have to take the test again?" Mrs. Mead said. Emily and Joe groaned. "This time, please follow all the directions," Mrs. Mead said. "First, write your name on your paper. Then answer the questions. When you're finished, bring me your test," Mrs. Mead said. Emily thought the test was easy. She didn't miss any questions. Joe thought it was hard. He missed 12 questions. Emily said, "Next time, I'll put my name on my paper." And Joe said, "Next time, I'll study for the test." "I could help you study," Emily offered. "Would you?" Joe asked. "Then maybe I'll do so well."